This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. As we continue to listen, learn, and grow, we are amplifying Black voices and perspectives in an effort to start a new COVID-19 vaccine conversation. We're sharing stories intended to help us navigate this unprecedented time together and to co-create solutions in support of the Black community. Hear these stories at WeConsiderWA.org.
GEICO asks, how would you love a chance to save some money on insurance? Of course you would. And when it comes to great rates on insurance, GEICO can help. Like with insurance for your car, truck, motorcycle, boat, and RV. Even help with homeowners or renters coverage. Plus, add an easy-to-use mobile app, available 24-hour roadside assistance, and more, and GEICO is an easy choice. Switch today and see all the ways you could save. It's easy. Simply go to GEICO.com or contact your local agent today.
What's up? It's your boy, The Fed Smith. Thanks for listening to the Men's Room Daily Podcast. Want more? Check out the greatest podcast in all the land, The Podcast. Be sure to subscribe and listen to a brand new episode every Tuesday night.
The debauchery rolls on. You're listening to The Men's Room with Miles and Thrill. 99.9 KISW.
Chronic Castle on the way. We will sit and spin with the 10 dumbest songs of all times. But first time for a few emails from The Men's Room at KISW.com.
You've got me.
Our question, what not-so-awesome thing happened to your head or face? We'll read one from the question today. Guys, I was sitting with my one-year-old son on my lap, and we were laughing at something. Suddenly, he threw his head back, and his bowling ball skull connected with a point of my cheekbone, leaving me with a rainbow shiner for several weeks. Here's a picture of the carnage. Mama still loves you, Torben. Man, I'll tell you what, kids can inflict a lot of damage.
Yeah, that's a shiner.
That is. On to the birthdays, let's see here. What do we got? Is that one for tomorrow? Send them a day off, people. I can't keep up with your crap. Just send them a day off.
Miles, what's our email address here?
It is themensroom@kisw.com.
Thank you.
Okay. Guys, I want to wish my firefighting brother Forbes a happy birthday. He makes another revolution on this planet. How about the dirty Germans teaching him how to properly play with his hose? Annie, your penis is too small. That is from his brother Mike.
Yeah, you will know if you placed with your hose correctly, because your hose should end up wet.
Yeah, you know, it's the funny thing about the firemen, it's a lot like the Germans. When the hose is ready to go, one of us just has to yell, charge!
Yeah.
So I believe that's what they yell, Mike. Charge the line. Charge the penis.
Guys, my wife Leslie turns 33 today. I want to hear the dirty Germans talk about her job as a GI tech doing colonoscopies all day. I've loved this woman for 14 years, and she is a kick-ass mom to the kids.
Yeah, I also do colonoscopies with my hands.
It's, yeah, let me feel around and see what's happening. It's, it looks clear from here.
Yeah.
So anyhow, let me take this glove off.
Let me give it another wiggle.
Yeah. Oh, there's nothing better as a German's legs and asking us to talk dirty to your wife. But hey, she's a hell of a mother.
Yeah.
It's a hell of a home movie, too.
I mean, in theory, she should be, like, into a lot of stuff, because she deals with the bad stuff all the time.
Yeah. I just couldn't believe it.
She might also be like, not tonight, I'm tired of buttholes.
Yeah, so, you know? Like, much like when I got a speeding ticket, they had a bunch of stills of my scooter and I going through the red light.
Yeah.
Okay, then they had the video. I mean, I wasn't going through the red light in my mind during the patients.
Of course.
Same thing with the
state of Washington said you were.
It, well, no, the video showed it clearly. I mean, there was no doubt about this. But the colonoscopy, same thing. So they take individual pictures.
Mm-hmm.
But if you want to see the whole ride through the tunnel, they got the video.
Oh, yeah.
You can watch the whole thing. Like, sit back and just, it's like taking a, it's you. You've never seen this part of your body before. But you get the whole tour of your caboodle.
Why did that become, you know, like, there's all these TikTok challenges. There's a time when it's like, Katie Couric going to share a colonoscopy. Like, and then a bunch of people did. Like, why do you think so many of us want to see your butthole? Like, how vain are you? Like, man.
Many veins, you can see.
Yeah, like, I don't want to see that. Just tell me if it's clean, right? If you're healthy, that's good. I don't need to see it.
Hey, guys, huge fan. Please wish my awesome mom, Colleen, a happy birthday. We've listened to you guys for so many years. Please give her the classic fish sandwich, a suck-it-up cupcake, and the dirty Germans talking about what she should do after her two strawberry margaritas tonight. Have a great Taco Tuesday, guys. That's from Crystal.
Two Oregon fish sandwich.
So, suck it up, cupcake!
Yeah, this is very easy. If you're going to have two strawberry daiquiris, have a third, and then two words for you. But play.
Yeah, I think it's, you know, so drinking the daiquiris, that's that certain color. It's after that, so you should keep that color near your mouth.
Patolos, for my 37th birthday, I would like some A Thrill Shotgun Gets, followed by a Drop the Beat and a Phone Dong, if you still got that thing. Thanks a lot, guys. That from Drew.
Get.
Drop the Beat.
Can I get a birthday shout-out to my sister, Jody, 52 years old today. She turned me on to your show several years ago, and I've been listening ever since. Please give her a Pat Sajak D and the Dirty Germans talking about her getting some much-needed action for her birthday. That from Jordan.
She wants a D, and she's going to get one.
Yeah, much-needed action. You've come to the right place, to the Dirty Germans. We'll split you in two, and that way it's like we're both with a 26-year-old.
Yeah. So, you know, hopefully you've done some travel, so you're familiar with the beauty. It's the stamina of the London Bridge. Jesus. High five, sir.
Yeah. All right, guys, here you go.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you.
Yaz the Dirty Germans, brought to you by Men's Room Original Sausage. Available through Uli's World Famous Sausage, mensroomlive.com, and other fine retailers. Schweinefleisch.
Thank you, Mom. A couple extra emails here. Subject is vasectomy. Fellas, just thought you'd appreciate that as I listened to the velvety sounds of the Men's Room, I was prepping for my vasectomy. Thank you and you're welcome. That from Matt in rainy Arizona. What you got for free? From our Monday random question. Guys, I painted inside a house, plus electrical and trim work. I was paid when finished. Then he gave me a compound miter saw, a 48-inch flat-screen TV, and a JVC receiver with a Bose 6-speaker sound system. Almost felt guilty. By the way, guys, when Thrill screwed up right out of the gate with the F-word on the Friday happy hour, I almost spit out my beer. Awesome show. P.S. Mike Hawk, you did an awesome job with the Steve Martin line. That from Yordi.
Thank you.
It was impressive.
Yeah, it was. It was really
good. You really sold it. Oh, by the way, a quick text came in. Says, in Katie Couric's defense, her husband died of colorectal cancer, so she wanted people to get checked. Mm-hmm. So I told him, yeah, well, now I feel like an a-hole.
What else we got here?
Oh. You know what? To be honest with you, I knew that. I just didn't feel like saying it to you. I knew there was a reason behind it, why she did it. But
no, I'm glad that, I'm not glad that's the reason. Just in my memory, like, who decided, hey, Katie, show him your butt.
We got, we were having a discussion not too long ago about the electric fence, not the kind that you would see, like, that you would pee on.
Yeah, the invisible fence.
The invisible fence that you put in the ground and you keep the dog in the yard, right? And we were wondering, like, could you just bolt through it, you know what I mean, and see if you could make a cut for it?
Because it was like, does it continue to shock you after you breach it, or how does it work?
So, the underground fence you guys were talking about does only shock the dog at the moment they cross the line. Then they're free. Which is why every single dog I've known with one has learned to charge through when they want out bad enough. The idea is that you're supposed to train them thoroughly so that they never get close enough to figure that out. But in my experience, they always do sooner or later. The only time they work well is if you do like the collar did and add them to a solid fence so the dog gets zapped while they're trying to dig under or climb over. And they just can't make a break for it. A bottom line, if you want a dog yard, build a solid fence. That from the Crazy Goat Lady.
Yes, friends, it's time once again for Sit and Spin. Let's gather around the old radio and listen to some swellerific new music.
Oh, look who it is from his basement dungeon studio, bartend situation, Ryan Castle. What's going on?
Oh, it's just a lovely day here, subterranean in North Seattle. Thanks for asking. How are you?
We're doing lovely. It's a wonderful day. Sure, yeah.
Sunshiny.
No, everything's going really good. Have you been checking out the new Men's Room Happy Hour on the Odyssey app there, Ryan?
I have. I don't know if you remember this, but I was on it on Friday.
Oh, that's right. I forgot all about that.
Oh, God, yeah.
I barely remember that myself.
It's different to be on it or to listen to it, I guess.
I have listened to it.
Yeah.
I have listened to some episodes of the Happy Hour. I enjoy it very much.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that was a good show. Aaron Jones was Friday night.
Side note. Everyone, including Aaron, tiny people in the band. I would not have known this, but Castle and I went up to do the stage announcement, and I realized you took the same posture I did, where you had to bend at the waist and lean down.
It was sort of a quasi-squat bend, you know, so from behind.
We looked great.
I call that the Sully Erna squat. Right. That microphone where you get
I like
down
to call it. Here's the look. Here's the look. Take the scene from Dumb and Dumber when he goes up to the bar to put out the vibe and he sticks his ass out. It's sort of that look.
That's the position we had to take just to reach the microphone.
Dude, I can't remember who it was. It might have been Tremonti. Somebody like that. I did a stage and it was the opposite. I had to be on my tippy toes.
Oh, he's a big dude.
That's a bad look.
I was like, he's also jacked.
Welcome to Elkers.
Hello.
Well, Castle. Since Ben, I know for a fact that you used to live and work in Minnesota. But I did. You're still a Viking fan, and I know
sometimes.
I know you read every day the Morrison County Record, the newspaper where we're pulling this list from today.
And you know, as far as research goes, I think this is a really great sample, and a lot of people who probably are the authority on the subject of what is the dumbest song of all time.
Right, just not even the worst. It's just dumbest.
But typically, even with children's songs, they're not that bad. You know what I mean? Like, even if you listen to Hell.
I mean, they're dumb by nature because you got to dial it down.
Yeah,
right?
I mean, Wiggles, Fruit Salad, Yummy. When they start playing it, you're like, I'm down with this. This is actually all right. This has kind of got a groove to it. I mean, I know it's about fruit salad. Not my favorite food.
But they've sold more records than AC/DC in Australia.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't understand it, but that is the truth.
But are these bands so that were actually trying to make a song that was not stupid and it just is dying?
I don't think so. Yeah, I think that's exactly why. Well, some of them are intentionally stupid. Some of them are kind of anomalies that I don't think were ever supposed to be big songs in the first place.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of all over the map. You know, I'm sure it was a very large sample of readers of the Morrison County Record that submitted their answers for this thing, though.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, it's like the Iowa caucus.
I mean, their circulation has got to be in the tens.
Right. All 30 of our readers responded. Right.
Yep. Had an opinion.
Okay. So this is according to a guy who writes a newspaper column again at the Morrison County Record, and he, I guess, just kind of, he's a musicologist, and he said, look, in my mind, he put out 20 songs that he thought were the dumbest songs that he'd ever heard in his life.
And it's so hard, you know, because like something like Mambo No. 5, I don't know if it's on the list or not. I don't know if that was supposed to be stupid, but it's stupid. Or Gangnam Style, or even Don't Worry, Be Happy. Like, to me, those are really... really dumb songs, and it's one thing if Weird Al Yankovic does it, that's what he's trying to do. But with these guys, like, it's funny if you did it on purpose. It's really not if you thought this was
well,
good.
Well, you know, I go back to a lot of Van Halen, too. They would always end it out.
Very stupid songs.
With dumb crap.
But they were awesome.
Happy Trails, I believe was the end of Diver Down, which is just, you know, bomba-dee-da, bomba-dee-da. And then they did Ice Cream Man, which does definitely kick ass at the end. But at the beginning
it's stupid.
It's a dumb song.
Yeah, there's
in the world.
A line in one of the Sammy Hagar Van Halen songs that always gets listed as some of the dumbest lyrics of all time, and that is, only time will tell if we stand the test of time.
Okay,
that's some Yogi Bear stuff,
right?
Yeah.
So
you just blew my mind, dude.
These are the 10 dumbest songs of all time.
10, number 10. It was an itsy bitsy teeny weeny yellow polka dot bikini that she wore for the first time today. An itsy bitsy teeny.
Yeah, this should be a commercial jingle.
I think it is.
It's been used
it
for
had to have been at some point.
But it wasn't originally.
You know, that guy was happy as hell, though, to see that thing. I mean, it inspired him. You know what I mean?
Right, like, so I mean, it's dumb, but also it's a hot chick in a bikini.
Right.
But this is the song you write for the hot chick? He did not get any play. He didn't get any
a different
ass.
Time throw.
Who
right, I'm assuming also at this time, it might have been the first bikini he saw.
I'm sure
I was going to say we were one step up from seeing ankles at that point. I mean, it was a big step.
And
it was a big step.
And he walked up and asked, is this the first time you've ever wore this? And she said, yes. Which is creepy.
And she said, mind your business, creep.
Get my pen and pad. I got to put this down.
Who did that, Ryan?
You know, it's funny. I just got kicked off my computer right as we started talking, so.
We don't know who that is.
Okay. I lost my list.
Ryan Hyland. Okay.
Everyone knows the song, though.
These are the 10 dumbest songs of all times on Sit and Spin.
Number 9. Oh, the chicken in the air. Stick the deck chair up your nose. Buy a jumbo jet.
What was that first one?
The Itsy Bitsy Teeny Weeny Yellow Polka Dot Bikini by Brian Hyland.
Brian Hyland.
Yes. What is this?
I don't know what this is. On my list, it's supposed to be the chicken song. I don't think this is the chicken song.
Oh, no, this is the chicken song.
It is
the
spinning
image.
Song.
Is it? I was thinking...
That's the dance, Ryan. That's the dance.
Oh, that's the chicken dance. Okay, gotcha.
Another dumb song.
These are the 10 dumbest songs of all time on Sit and Spin.
Number 8.
Yep. Oh, yeah.
It's like a Red Hot Chili Peppers song where you just don't have any words, so you just make sounds.
Yeah, but at least he waits until the end.
Ding, dang, dee, dang, dang, ding, dong.
I want to do some karaoke just to watch the words on the screen.
It's catchy. Who is this?
This is Eiffel 65. Had the internet in 1999 remembers this song.
Yeah, I remember this tune. I don't know why.
It was popular for a minute there. It was everywhere. Especially like on MTV. You saw it a lot.
These are the 10 dumbest songs of all time.
It is dumb.
Number 7.
Saying, wait, This doesn't sound like the Talking Heads. That's because it's not. This is specifically the Talking Wallfish, Big Mouth Billy Bass's version of Take Me to the River from the Talking Heads.
Did Big Mouth Billy Bass make this song stupid?
No. Well, no.
He made it stupider.
Right.
Yeah, but was it the Reverend, is it Al Green, who originally did this? I think he made more money off of that commercial and off that bass than he did the song.
Think about this. Al Green made more money in his entire recording career because of Billy the Big Mouth Bass singing that goddamn song than he did from anything else.
That's insane. These are the 10 dumbest songs of all time.
Since number 6.
Oh, well, everybody's heard about the bear.
Sure that this is that dumb.
No, it's dumb, but it's awesome.
Dumb. It's pretty dumb, but it is amazing. It's absolutely amazing. Yeah, that's a Surf and Bird from the Trashmen in 1963.
See?
And if anybody ever asks what the word is, you know the answer, of course, is that the bird is the bird.
Yeah! It's so addictive. It's like cocaine.
I see Peter Griffin dancing.
That's all I see every time I hear this song.
You know they're all.
This is the day the Trashmen discovered cocaine. They wrote this song.
I'm telling you. These are the 10 dumbest songs of all time.
Number 5.
This is from 1971, and I can't help but think it's like parents' euphemism for sex when their kids are around. You know, chick-a-boom, don't you love it?
I do remember it was Daddy Dewdrop, which just sounds really, really dirty in its own way.
It does. That
sounds
could be
like
also,
what you wipe off on your
that
sock.
That could be a euphemism.
Daddy
Dewdrop,
our baby, ready to go back
Daddy Dewdrop on you.
We slide on into the back of my trailer.
Uh-huh.
Find this out. These are the 10 number songs ever.
The Daddy Dewdrop. That's great.
4.
Look, I think people who love Frank Zappa will say he never wrote a stupid song. And people that don't know Frank Zappa probably think most of his songs are pretty stupid. Colony Vegetable from Frank Zappa and the Mothers of Invention from 1970.
Yeah, I like the music part, but the lyrics are a little out there.
That's Frank Zappa.
Calling a Vegetable.
That's Frank Zappa.
I prefer Muffin weird. Man. These are the 10 dumbest songs of all time.
Number 3.
I mean, when I was a child, this was awesome. Now that I'm not, it's nothing but stupid. And it wasn't basically just like Rick Dees could do the duck voice, and they wrote the entire song around
I'm surprised that Bachman and Garcia and Pac-Man Fever is on this list either.
Yeah.
That was at the same point in time, and it was just as horrible as this.
I think this is before Disney sued everyone for using their stuff. Or was Donald was Disney, right? Yeah.
They still allow the orange juice in Oregon. That's about it, I think, on Donald.
Yeah, right, the duck at Oregon.
Yeah,
just because him and Walt were buddies.
Mm-hmm.
These are the 10 dumbest songs of all time.
Number 2.
What does the fox say?
My kids sing this song so goddamn much. It got to the point I was going to punish them if they kept singing.
This was an internet phenomenon in 2013, which remarkably was, 7 years ago?
Yeah. I mean, look, eight I only know ago. It because my niece and nephews, they were much smaller right. at that point, and like, every time I saw them, this was our song.
What does the fox say?
I have no goddamn idea.
Ding, 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 ding.
Oh, that fox is right in it. Big blue eyes, mama. Yeah.
These are the,
I got rabies. She's like one of them furry foxes.
10 dumbest songs of all time, so we made it to number one.
Number one.
There you go, Pacific Northwesterners and rock and roll legends, The Kingsmen, at number one.
This is a dumbass song.
This song had its own FBI file. That's how
cool it
was, though. Right, that part still boggles my mind. Yeah, the FBI
the irony
so
of all of this. The irony of all of this is there's actually a bad word in this song, and no one ever caught it. So they actually were breaking the law, but nobody ever knew.
Because they couldn't understand
F-bomb.
Them.
There's an F-bomb in this song, and everyone was playing it on the radio. But they were looking for, like, the hidden meaning.
We probably just heard it and don't even know.
I know.
Who knows?
Thank you, Ryan Castle. We appreciate it. There you go. And since been in the 10 dumbest songs of all times, you are listening to The Men's Room.
This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. As we continue to listen, learn, and grow, we are amplifying Black voices and perspectives in an effort to start a new COVID-19 vaccine conversation. We're sharing stories intended to help us navigate this unprecedented time together and to co-create solutions in support of the Black community. Hear these stories at WeConsiderWA.org.
GEICO asks, how would you love a chance to save some money on insurance? Of course you would. And when it comes to great rates on insurance, GEICO can help. Like with insurance for your car, truck, motorcycle, boat, and RV. Even help with homeowners or renters coverage. Plus, add an easy-to-use mobile app, available 24-hour roadside assistance, and more, and GEICO is an easy choice. Switch today and see all the ways you could save. It's easy. Simply go to GEICO.com or contact your local agent today.
Start summer up by mixing things up with top paint and stain brands at Lowe's. Shop HGTV Home by Sherwin-Williams, Valspar, Cabot to find the perfect pop of color or classic shade you've been looking for. And don't forget to prep your deck for the season with reliable wood stain and sealer. Now's the perfect time to complete your paint or stain project. Lowe's. All things summer, all at the right price.
Take the next step toward the career you want, be it business, cybersecurity, healthcare, or more. UMGC can help you get there. No application fee when you apply by August 31st. Visit umgc.edu, certified to operate by Chev.
99.9 KISW. The Men's Room is in progress.
Coming up in just minutes, we will drink, we will toast with a shot of the day. And we do have your headlines on the way 1 hour from now. First, quick check in with Mike Hawk and some of the stories and headlines he is not working on.
All right, this is kind of sad. Reports are going around that flight attendants are taking self-defense classes.
They should.
So that they can handle unruly passengers.
They put a moratorium out on a couple airlines. You're not allowed to duct tape passengers to their seat anymore.
I disagree with that.
If they misbehave. I'm thinking to myself, if you're to that point, you probably should be duct taped to your seat.
I don't think there's any flight attendant out there that is irresponsibly duct taping a passenger.
Either that or you got to go work for Air Emirates. Or Virgin, or somebody like that. You cannot work for a commercial airline here in the United States and not expect to have some kind of crap go down.
Because now we can't have nice things at all. Now, granted,
No, it's crazy. I mean, look, they're flight attendants. They shouldn't need self-defense classes.
Right.
Like, you know, like now, like what America's like, no booze for like the rest of the year or 2022 as well. It's like, you know, at the end of the, like it used to be you had to be pretty drunk and they'd go, okay, we can't serve you, but...
But we didn't respond with violence. What's the difference?
Right. But I'm also saying, like, they shouldn't have to be, like, bartenders or self-defense people. No. They're flight attendants. That's their job is to do that job.
Look, I've seen three different videos of just people at athletic events rooting for the same team.
Right.
Getting in fights with each other in the stands. It's not like you're wearing the other team's jersey or we're jawing back and forth. These are people rooting for the same team.
Right. You're from the same area here.
People are losing their mind. I mean, they're losing it.
They are, man. I don't get it. Like, I understand that you're stressed out, but quit acting out against other people, man. That ain't okay.
We're all in the same boat.
We are.
We're all in the same plane. We're all in the same stadium.
Exactly. You should be able to play. Take a breath. Easy. A man in the hospital on a ventilator is suing the hospital after a pipe burst, dumping hundreds of gallons of human wastewater on him. We covered that yesterday. That's fun.
Oh, my God, they say, well, human wastewater. No, poop.
Right.
With some water. Yeah. Exactly. He's not upset about the waste water.
There's toilet
He's
water.
He's worried about the waste.
Which is contaminated by urine, liquid feces.
Yeah. Good I mean, times. That's the thing. It's liquid feces at that point. Like, and we're calling that water now.
Hey. If it was just in his room, it wouldn't matter. No. Straight onto the guy.
On him.
Mm-hmm. Goodness.
It was
gracious.
Only him. Just his room.
And just him on his bed in his spot.
What's that?
But his mom tried to cover him. And also nurses ran in to the credit.
Sure.
You know, I mean, if I'm a nurse, I'm like, well, you know, you're on your own.
We need to get this stopped.
Oh, what do we do?
Somebody hit an emergency pipe. Oh, dear. That's got to... I would hope if I was in that situation, much like your situation a while back, it would be a it's not funny yet situation. I will look back on this and laugh at the fact that I was on a ventilator. Now, granted, this is a very bad situation, and he is nowhere near laughing at this point in his life.
I don't know that he ever looks back on this. My kid peed on my lap.
Yeah.
I can look back and laugh at that. He did not pull down his pants.
That's true.
And spray diarrhea on me. And even then, I might laugh later because it's my kid, but right. Not, I'm on a ventilator in the hospital, and hundreds of gallons of stranger's poop rain down on me. Like, there's no funny to me. I mean, it's funny to me because it didn't happen to me. But
right.
Yeah.
Oh, dear. Lucky Charms is bringing back their marshmallows-only cereal. Yay.
Marshmallows only.
Come on.
That's a healthy way to start the day.
Yeah. Is that just for kids and stoners?
No.
They're going to say it's for kids. I bet you more stoners and adults buy that.
Would you ever wake up in the morning and make yourself ice cream sundae or a milkshake or a s'more for breakfast?
Not a s'more, but the other
breakfast
two.
Breakfast cereals aren't really, for the most part, like the bastion of health in
no,
the morning.
That's sure. Why they say it's part of a suggested daily diet. And everything else they show is not cereal.
But at the same time, when I was a kid, I feel like I had their marshmallows only cereal, and it was too much. After a while, missed the dryness and the blandness of the cereal between it.
I also grew up with a cereal called Cookie Crisp.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
But same thing. Like, if but you wouldn't wake up and go, here's cookies.
Yeah. I mean, like Raisin Bran.
But if we call it cereal and put it in milk.
Yeah.
Raisin Bran, not without bran, just raisins.
I wasn't allowed to have Cookie Crisp. We weren't going to have just bowls of cookies in my household.
What was your cereal?
I don't necessarily disagree with that.
No, I don't disagree with that either. Corn Pops were really, really good.
Graham's were solid.
Kicks.
I was gonna say Pops are big in my house.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm with you. I don't know any kid that actually ate Cookie Crisp outside of like a Saturday morning or something.
Rice Krispies.
When it was like a special treat.
Ooh, Corn Chex.
Ew, man.
Really?
Yeah, really.
Oh, they're great.
I mean, I still
Honey Nut Cheerios.
Honey Nut Cheerios to this day is still probably the best.
Yeah, man. We should have a cereal taste test in here one time. That'd be fun.
Did you ever eat Life?
No.
Yeah. It was the commercials were cool to me when I was a kid. So my parents bought it. I'm not Mikey. I did not like it.
Uh-huh. I am Mikey. I didn't like it.
Yeah.
Frosted Flakes. That was my jam.
Frosted Flakes is probably
that
the
was
biggest.
My favorite cereal, man. We've talked about it a little bit. The new TikTok stupid plaguing social media, the Milk Crate Challenge. If you haven't seen it, it's absolutely stupid. Basically, what's the highest that it gets? Like 8 crates tall, something like that. And that is your center pillar. And from there, it stair steps down either side. And you need to walk up one side all the way to the tip top and down the other side. On this single stack of milk crates.
It's not going well for most people.
As you can imagine, when you get up to that 8 stacker or even 5, I don't know how tall it is, but it gets a little bit wobbly after a while. Mm-hmm. So it's the big challenge is that if you can make it up and over the pyramid. A lot of people are failing really, really badly. Exercise caution, i.e., don't do it.
Don't disrespect what I used as furniture in my early 20s.
Hell yeah.
Make a coffee table out of that. Shelving for clothes.
Say shelving was great.
Yeah. Somebody made a good point, though. Where do you get those these days?
Milk crates?
Yeah, back in the day when the milkman was coming around, maybe, but not today, man. How in the hell do you find those things?
Probably just go to the grocery store and steal them. Honestly, that's the one place that I ever see milk crates.
That's a great call. Like, I don't know. Right, outside of like a DJ buddy that still like uses vinyl.
Sure.
Right?
Mm-hmm. Good news for all you.
Where did he get them?
Right. Well, he probably stole them. He's a DJ.
Good news for all you fans of the fall season. The pumpkin spice latte is already back.
Can we at least wait till September?
Right.
Can we wait till Labor Day, right? That's fair.
Can the leaves change for a second? Like, I'm not even thinking about
right,
pumpkins
you're
yet.
You're still allowed to wear white for, like, a week.
Right. The pumpkins are still green. Can we not? Goodness gracious. 25% of young adults say that they work harder than previous generations.
How would you know?
Right.
I mean, that's also I mean, a huge argument. Are you talking about, like, physical hard work? Are
right.
you talking about hours you're supposed to be on the clock?
Right.
You can be now.
Mental hard work.
Physical
workload.
Hard work.
Yeah.
And again, like Miles said, how the F do you know, man? You don't know what life was like back in the 50s. Therefore, you don't know what it was like to work.
I'm glad I wasn't there.
Right.
I know that.
I'd be dead now.
Right. Technology wasn't what it was. You know, so what is easy for us today was not easy back then. You know, there was a day when you, if you were digging a ditch, it was guys with pickaxes and shovels.
And you actually worked. You weren't distracted by your computer, your phone, all those things.
Right.
It wasn't, you know, you stopped for lunch.
I mean,
for
it's just a little thing. Well, even if you had to type something, you know, there's no spell check. You typed.
Right.
And if you effed up, then you typed it again. By the way, the typewriter we had, a big old Royal typewriter. Right?
We had an IBM.
I remember, yeah, and I like the sound of it. It forces you just to spell better and concentrate a little more.
Sure.
But I remember my father asking me, I'm like 10 years old maybe, oh, can you bring the typewriter upstairs? This is not like lifting a laptop. This is like picking up a Volkswagen Beetle, trying to carry this goddamn thing up the stairs. And, you know, fathers were a little help, but you better not drop it. I'm like, bro, right. This thing weighs like 800 pounds. My hands are sweating, you know.
Lift with your legs, son. Don't put it in your back.
Right, like I was lucky. My mom was a secretary as long as I can remember.
Yeah.
So it was just easy to kind of get papers typed because she could just sit there and run through it.
Oh, yeah. My grandmother, when they switched to kind of a digital deal, they had a little screen on there. She'd outrun the memory of the screen because she was so used to typing documents. She gets a quick at it.
Dude, I've said this before. My mom can write in shorthand.
Yep, my mom can too.
Oh, my goodness.
It's wild.
And not only that.
And they're the only two people that can communicate with each other.
here's high school Miles, Mike.
I don't need this typing class. When am I going to type anything other than school?
That was always the thing.
Why?
Never. What am I going to type?
What am I going to type? You know what I mean? Like, seriously, when I'm done with school, I don't need to do that.
Is that why you type with single fingers there, Miles? I can see it every day.
I call that the hunt and peck method there, Mike.
Because
I have that kind of attitude. I know everything.
I mean, mine are kind of where they should be, but I feel like I'm still kind of hunting and pecking a bit.
Well, trust me, if the letters have been worn off, from overuse on a keyboard, I'm like,
damn it. I don't have an M key.
I'm not sure where that is.
Is it going to work if I push it?
Back.
Our friends at therap.com.
Trying to hit R because that one in there, like the letters are gone.
Oh, they're hosed, absolutely. Our friends over at therap.com made a list of movies that are good, but you only need to see them one time. So that
ooh.
Right? Everybody, I feel like, has that movie that they will talk up unless like crazy.
Unless it's Ted. Because I'll say things like Full Metal Jacket, right? It is a very good movie.
Sure.
It is so depressing and
very
stressing.
Dark movie.
And Ted will be like, I don't know why I do it. I just watched it again. I'm like, what are you doing?
Only if I have a vacation day and I've got nothing to do, I watch depressing movies.
And that's kind of the...
You really do.
I know. But if I'm on an airplane, Mike, I watch rom-coms.
And but you've seen the depressing. It's not like you're watching it to say, hey, let me see what the hype's about. Like, yeah, I've seen it. I cry every time.
Right. That's kind of what this list is about. You know, the Saving Private Ryans of the era.
Just watched it.
Great movie.
Jesus
but
Christ.
If you just want to, you know, sit back and cry one afternoon, you go ahead and watch Saving Private Ryan. So here's your list of 10 movies that are good, but you only need to see them one time. Number 10, it's called City of God. It came from 2002. I haven't even heard about this movie. However, it says this Brazilian film depicts kids killing kids in street gang warfare.
Okay. I've seen part of it.
I can't see why it would be dark enough to where you would only want to watch this one.
Well, that's the thing. Like, it's a really good movie, but yeah, like I said, I saw a part, and I'm like, good enough.
Yes. Number 9, I believe this one actually won Best Picture, 12 Years a Slave in 2013.
Uh-huh.
Lupita Nyong'o's character receives life-threatening lashes and is repeatedly, I hate that word so much. We're moving on. Movies that are good but only need to be seen once. Number 8, The Revenant. From 2015, and it just says in big capitalized letters, Bear Attack.
I have not seen it.
Oh, my God.
Everyone was espousing how good this is.
Yes.
Chris Cornell came in, and he brought up The Revenant, and he's like, I'll be honest with you, man. I thought it sucked. He's like,
kidding.
He did not like it at all. He was just like, yeah, dude's attacked by a bear. Get it. And then he's just mad the rest of the movie.
Because
that was basically how
he's
like
a magazine cover with DiCaprio on it. Because that movie had been out. And he just kind of picked it up. And then, started this conversation. He's like,
You didn't like
it? Wasn't for him.
No, not at all.
I've never seen it.
I did enjoy the movie, and you guys know me. I'm a horror movie fan, so I had seen all the gore. I've watched all the Saw movies, so I've seen probably the worst things you could do to a human being. That one made me cringe. Like, they did so well with this bear attack, and they made it feel so real, and you felt all the pain that was going through. Like, it gets intense.
That's why I felt about that movie, The Gray.
Oh, yes.
All those goddamn wolves.
Damn, man. Same.
By the way, someone here says Schindler's List. I don't know if it's on there, but that is their suggestion.
Wait for it. Movies that are good but only need to be seen once. Number 7, 127 Hours.
Oh, that's the dude who was stuck under the rock.
Correct.
In Utah.
Oh, the guy who cut his arm off.
Exactly.
That 2010. Says what,
is that James Franco?
Yeah. Yep, James Franco cutting off his arm. That was one I actually felt sick to my stomach when it happened because he's kind of in this state of spoiler alert. He's in this state of delirium when he's about to go through with it. Like he's on hour 126. Like he's done with this stuff, and then he finally just kind of leans into it, and then you hear both bones snap. And they make it thick snaps. It just made me sick.
If you know nothing about it, it is based on a true story. And it's not like it happened a million years ago.
Oh,
this guy told a story a couple years later. They made that movie.
Exactly.
Yeah,
exactly.
He broke his own arm so that he could cut through it easier with his knife because his hand was trapped under a bolt.
And his knife was dull.
Right.
Mm-mm-mm. Yeah. Number 6, Hotel Rwanda. Never seen it. I have heard about it, so I have no idea what it's about. However, it says the horrors of genocide are depicted. So I imagine it's, you know.
Says it right there.
Is that the one movies? With
Don Cheadle, I believe, is in it.
Okay, gotcha. Good times. Movies that are good but only need to be seen once. Number 5, American History X. Another one that I've heard of. I've seen posters for it. I've never.
I could watch that one again.
Yeah, that's not. Actually, I was thinking that's doable again.
It starts uglier than it ends, I believe.
What is the scene that everybody says kind of makes it intense?
Probably the sound of teeth on a curb.
Yeah, the curb stomping scene. That is a tough watch. Like, that is one thing that I have only ever heard of. And if it's ever brought up in any kind of fashion, it scares the living daylights out of me.
That's not it in that movie. There's a lot of terrible, terrible stuff.
Don't worry, it gets worse.
But with thrill, I've definitely watched it multiple times.
Yeah.
God.
It's a really good movie.
Yeah.
And number 4 is where we get our textures movie here. Schindler's List from 1993. Steven Spielberg's Holocaust film is deeply moving and won 7 Oscars, and it is horribly depressing. You will feel terrible about yourself. I did break down watching it.
I've never had anyone invite me to the Schindler's List party.
No.
You know what I mean? Come on over, all watching it.
Right. Yeah, everyone gather. Cool.
Great work by Liam Neeson, Ben Kingsley. I mean,
no
great
reason
all
to bring any snacks. We won't be hungry.
No, right. You will not. So what else could be on here? Movies that are good but only need to be seen once. Number 3, Deliverance from 1972.
Yep, absolutely.
Yep, and it's the scene that you guys are all thinking of. It says the rape scene is something you'll need bleach from your mind.
Yes! That is the entire
screaming
reason
in terror
you don't need to see it again.
It's about to be sodomized. Number 2, Pink Flamingos. I've never even heard of this one, but it's from 1972.
John Waters. Yeah, it's a John Waters flick, and it's just got some Divine.
I believe it's
just got a couple things where you go, hey, ho.
It's kind
of shocked like Deer Hunter's not on there.
No, it is not. This is the number 1 movie that is good, but you only need to see it once. Kind of a classic horror movie. A Clockwork Orange. Never seen it.
Yeah.
I have heard a lot of people talk about it. It is one of the most referenced movies out there from 1971. It says it initially received an X rating in the U.S., and the aversion therapy scenes are difficult to watch.
It was a lot of those. Deer Hunter.
Yeah, I mean, it's Stanley Kubrick, so it's a little slow-moving, but everything about it is disturbing.
He's
however,
twisted,
you can see David Prowse, the man in the Darth Vader outfit, in that movie.
Oh, no kidding.
You would not know it's him, but yeah.
Huh, I like it. A man in North Carolina took his Corvette out for one last hurrah before he sold it, and it didn't go as planned there, Miles.
What happened?
Tell you all about it 1 hour from now.
Thank you, Mike Hawk. Headlines are on the way 1 hour from now. In the meantime, let's get a contestant on the line for Profile This at 206-421-ROCK. All right, have we made it to drink a time?
This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. As we continue to listen, learn, and grow, we are amplifying Black voices and perspectives in an effort to start a new COVID-19 vaccine conversation. We're sharing stories intended to help us navigate this unprecedented time together and to co-create solutions in support of the Black community. Hear these stories at WeConsiderWA.org.
GEICO asks, how would you love a chance to save some money on insurance? Of course you would. And when it comes to great rates on insurance, GEICO can help. Like with insurance for your car, truck, motorcycle, boat, and RV. Even help with homeowners or renters coverage. Plus, add an easy-to-use mobile app, available 24-hour roadside assistance, and more, and GEICO is an easy choice. Switch today and see all the ways you could save. It's easy. Simply go to geico.com or contact your local agent today.
Start summer up by mixing things up with top paint and stain brands at Lowe's. Shop HGTV Home by Sherwin-Williams, Valspar, Cabot to find the perfect pop of color or a classic shade you've been looking for. And don't forget to prep your deck for the season with reliable wood stain and sealer. Now's the perfect time to complete your paint or stain project. Lowe's. All things summer, all at the right price.